What exactly is TDD or test-driven development? TDD stands for test-driven development. It is also known as the test-first approach. TDD is a software development process which we are using to develop software in an agile context. The first appearance it made in 1999 in extreme programming. But TDD is not only a software development process, it is also a mindset. A mindset that the first thing you always do when you are going to touch code is to write a test. Let's have a look how this looks like. You have this diagram over here which shows the process. So when you are going to touch code, write new features or fixing a bug, the first thing you are going to do with TDD is write a test. As soon as you have written the test, you execute the test and you will see a red test because there is no functionality behind what you just have written. Then you are going to write the functionality that makes this test pass. Then you have a green test. With that, you are going into the refactoring step. In the refactoring step, you're going to clean up the code and you're going to execute again the tests to see if your refactoring has not broken anything. And then you are going to write another test for another functionality, and so on and so on. This is how test-driven development works. Let's see how TDD works in a real-life code example. Here you can see Visual Studio Code with C#, but TDD can be used with any IDE or any programming language. Our task is to implement a calculator, especially adding two numbers. What I have created here is a calculator test class with a test method which will check if the add method will sum up the numbers. I've also created here some comments for the arrange, act and assert. In the arrange, we will create a new calculator. So let me quickly have that calculator here. Now we have a calculator and you can see the calculator is not yet created. Then we will go and use this calculator and add two numbers. We will take 1 + 1 and again this method is, of course, not yet generated, and we need to now assert this if they are equal. And for that, of course, we need to have here the result. So now we get the result back, and the result should be 2. And if not, we will have a problem. So you can see now, in very few code steps, I've created a first test where I test adding two numbers. Now I will execute this and you can see there were build errors. Of course, he says the calculator is not yet there and that's a problem. Let me create this calculator. Now we have created this calculator up here and we will again execute our tests. And again, we have a problem, of course, the add method is not yet there. I generate now this add method and I again execute the tests. Now the build is now working, but we can see up here that we still have, of course, a problem because it throws a system not implemented exception. Let's go into our calculator And we can see we have here our add method, which throws a not implemented exception. So of course we want to add two numbers. We need to return here v1 plus v2. And we again execute the tests. And you can see we have now a green test. And now we can go into the refactoring step. I will skip that, but just to say, of course, we need to now edit this return type and of course also do some refactorings on the naming. And then we can add another test and another test and another test. This is how test-driven development works. It's absolutely great and I can highly recommend that. Don't write any code without writing first a test. And as always, if you like this video, please leave me a thumbs up and subscribe to this video because I will create every week a new video for you.